Alright, hello again folks, welcome back to some more LEGO The Lord of the Rings. We're in the home stretch of the story now. This is going to be level 14, Cirith Ungol. As you can see here, got an achievement called We Did It, Mr. Frodo, which is simply for completing the level, as well as a true adventure of 54,000, which of course we're gonna get. But as you can see here, we're just loading in into Middle Earth, and we're just gonna make our way up this path, and we're gonna start with cutscene. Here we are now inside the level. Didn't take us too long to get in here, but as you can see, we've got an intense battle against the giant spider known as Shelob here. As you can see, we just ran around to the back of the area and picked up Frodo's sword and his file, of course, because as you can see, Frodo is trapped there in the spider web in the back there. But anyways, what you're going to do is you have to use the file and walk up to the spider, so approach it, and it'll start to kind of like walk back away from you a little bit, and then at that point you can use the sword to actually stab the spider in the chest. Then the spider is going to crawl up onto the wall in the back up top, and you have to throw the file up at it to deal a bit of damage. As you can see, we're doing it for the second time now, so you can see we just stabbed it. Then we're throwing the file up top to it. And for some reason, this time, we had to throw it two times. I'm going to assume it's going to be the same for you. But yeah, we had to throw the file up at it two times. As you can see, there were also some little spiders as well that'll attack you. But anyways, one last time. Scare away the spider a little bit, then we're gonna attack it some more, stab it here, and you can see it takes us up onto the wall. We're gonna attack it a little bit more, and down here, after this little bit of button mashing, we're gonna do a cutscene.
Hands off that shiny shirt. That's mine.
It's going to the Great Eye.
I don't take orders from stinking mortal rats.
Sam, they took the ring.
Begging your pardon, but they haven't.
Here's a new area. We're inside this massive tower. The orcs obviously took us in. But yeah, we have to make our way through this tower. Of course, just starting out with a smashing smashing everything for some extra studs, because 54,000, I mean, it's not too difficult, but, you know, of course, always smashing everything is just going to make getting to adventure easier. Of course, also do have a track studs on, which you should as well. Of course, if you don't have track studs, do check out the video I made for it, because it is pretty handy. But anyways, when you're ready, in the middle, use Sam's rope to pull on that hook, which will kind of drop the like chandelier there a little bit. So it's barely hanging on there, but I use this little stone in the front, throw it up at the chandelier, and it'll drop through the ground, and it'll crush that orb. So now we can drop down this rope to get below this lower section of the tower. Then after taking out a couple of these orcs and everything around the room, you can see a little bit of a dark cave over there on the left. Of course, there are actually a few blue studs around the area, which I recommend you pick up. You can see here, we're next to a little bit of a dark cave. So, of course, we're going to use Frodo to light it up. And in there, we can actually grab a little gear. So we'll place that over there in the wall in the back. Then the gears will do their thing and lower some chains. So hang on each of the chains. Then you'll be able to head through down the stairs here, and you'll notice some purple start up there. You can see I made a bit of a tricky jump up onto that handheld there, and then I was able to get that purple start without collecting that minikit. But yeah, anyways, we're gonna proceed to the bottom of the stairs here, where there is just a group of orcs and urukai. So we'll take them all out, of course, that's how we roll. Of course, we're also gonna grab as many studs as possible, because that's also how we roll. But yeah, you'll notice a couple silver like boxes here. Again, that's all gonna be free play related, which again, we are getting ever so much closer to. I'm just trying to bust through these last couple story videos, so then we can get into the real nitty gritty, the free play, because that's really the best part of this all, isn't it? Again, story's great, but free play is just more fun, isn't it? But anyways. As you can see, we just took out all the orcs and urukai around the area, then a couple more are going to bust through the door, and we'll be able to head outside to get to this outside area, where you can see there's a bit of a safe statue there, or a safe statue, not a bit of a, there's an actual safe statue there. As you can see, this is just kind of showing us what we're going to be doing. You can see orcs there. They've got some armor on, and what we need to do is we need to locate 4 bits of orc armor around the area, and we got to use that to like disguise ourselves, so we can proceed through the like outposts there, and that'll allow us to proceed into Mordor, which is exciting. But anyways, just getting to move on here. Taking out some stuff. You can notice a minikit all the way up there in the back. We'll get to that, of course, later. But yeah, over here on the right, you can see a little stone there just lying on the ground. We'll pick that up, and we're going to throw it up at the pipe up there, which will cause some like goo to spill out from the pipe down onto the orc, who needs to take a shower. So he drops into the shower over there on the right, and leaves behind his armor, which is nice. Then what we'll do is we'll just pick up the armor as either Frodo or Sam place that on. And so yeah, that's the first bit of armor. So for Frodo and Sam, they each need an armor and a helmet. So we've got Frodo's armor dealt with. Now we're gonna proceed over here to the right to this more open section. You can see just smashing some stuff up for some more studs. Yeah, you can see a little purple stud up there in that little compartment. We'll pick that up with our track studs, of course. Then, you can see in the back there, those are little outposts. That's what we've got to head through to get into Mordor. Once we've got our disguises on. But, yeah. Anyways, over here on the right, you can see a little bit of a fire spot in the back. You can see some firewood here. Also, there you go, true adventure we did pick up, which is nice, in 54,000. But anyways, once you're ready, use Sam here in the back to light this wood on fire. Then that'll burn the flag there. Then just hang on that like rope there, which will move that like wood stuff along, and it'll burn down. And then you can build the parts into some sort of like catapult machine there. But before we use that, I'm gonna grab a couple more studs. Yeah, basically, I do wanna kind of mention about the multipliers. Originally, I was gonna grab a design in a story level. In fact, it was actually the next story level, level 15. I was gonna grab a blacksmith design there in story, use that. But the red brick that one unlocks is like, it's a useful red brick multiplier, but it costs 8 million. So there was gonna have to be so much stuff from. So instead, what I'm gonna do is, after story, I'm gonna do like a free play preparations video, where we'll just we'll dip into an earlier level and actually pick up a design there, which will help us get a much cheaper red brick multiplier, which only costs just 1 million. But yeah, so that'll be here just after completing story. We'll do a free play preparations video, and don't worry, we'll cover all that here soon enough. But anyways, use that catapult machine there to launch yourself up onto this higher ledge, as Sam, and then you can use this rope to get yourself up top. Then over here in the corner, push those barrels down the stairs there, which will take out the orc, and drop some parts below, as well as a helmet. So we're going to pick up that helmet as Sam here. You could pick it up as Frodo as well if you want. But you can also see in there, in that little cubby hole, a couple blue studs and a purple, so be sure to pick them up as well. But there you go, you can see now Sam's helmet is dealt with. So we got one helmet and one armor plate done. Anyways, build up that ladder, then head up it. So that'll basically just allow Frodo to get up here, because Sam can already get up using his robe. But anyways, over here on the left, there's some sort of orc in here. There's an orc in there with in that like outpost, and basically if you try to walk past, he'll lower that gate. So what we gotta do is we gotta use Frodo, pull out his elven cloak, and he's gonna transform into a box. Then you'll be able to sneak past the orc. You can see here I swapped out of the elven cloak a bit too early, but you can just transform back into the box. And then make your way past the orc without being detected. Which I don't know how he isn't questioning a massive moving box, but I'm not one to question it. Anyways, then make your way up onto the roof here via the ladder. Then pick up that rock there. Then on the other side of the roof, break that barrel and pick up the stick, which you can combine with the rock to assemble a hammer here. Smash through that crack there in the middle, and you'll drop down into the outpost here. Spin the crank, and that'll open the door so you can exit out. But before doing that, pick up the helmet, and that's Frodo's helmet handled. So now we've got two helmets and one armor plate. Now we just need one last armor plate. So anyways, over here on the left, burn down this wood as Sam, which will clear the path here, so we can head through. That'll also lower a chain, so if you do happen to drop down, you can just make your way back up that way. Then over here on the left, push these two crates down off the edge of the roof, which will cause them to drop down below and smash into a bunch of pieces. We'll get down below to there, but we're gonna run down these stairs first, take out that rock for some extra studs. But then once you're ready, build up the two sets of parts into these little checkered tiles. And then once that's done, we're gonna head over to the left, and we're gonna jump onto the, we're gonna first push down this little, like, wooden tower, all the way over to the far right side, then jump onto it, smash through the little, wall there, then put on the armor plate, and, with that, you should have both disguises fully put together. So now, just, use your disguises, talk to the two orcs here on either outpost, and once you've done so, the gates will open, and that is gonna do it.
We did it, Mr. Frodo. We made it to Mordor.
It's him. We'll never get through unseen.
Come on. Let's just make it down the hill for starters.
And there we go. That is going to do it. We did it, Mr. Frodo. And indeed we did. We have made it into Mordor. As you can see there, Frodo and Sam, both in their orc disguises, unlocked. As well as Shagrath, who was the dude we played as at the beginning. With Sam, I mean, I don't think I even used him, but he was there. He's some, like, orc guy. He's trouble, for sure. But another bunch of studs added to the collection. We got well over the 54,000 required. And there you go. We're now over 1.3 million. We got two more mythical bricks added to the collection. And, that's going to do it for level 14 Cirith Ungol. Seriously, we do not have much story left, which is most definitely exciting, but anyways, if you enjoyed this one, a like would certainly be appreciated, but until next one, we'll see you folks later. See you, everybody. Bye.